okay start in this one. Okay, all set to go. Now the left fielder, Randy Arozarena.
Randy Arozarena.
The pitch. That one's in there. And we are underway in game one of the series. And a base hit into right. And the leadoff man aboard.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. When you see a ball come off the bat like that, you know it was pretty much a perfect swing. And for me, you know, I start wondering.
But Arozarena on the move. Pitch in for a strike. Throw to second. Great jump.
Well, he's batting leadoff, and he's acting like a traditional leadoff hitter. Gets on base to start the game, then puts himself on second with a nice stolen bag. I think that sets the tone for the offense for sure.
Here comes a pitch. Check swing went around. Oh, a tuna. Ground ball right side. Whips it to first. One out in the top of the first. Now a look at Kevin Cash's lineup for the Tampa Bay Rays. And a key factor for this club in that leadoff spot, Randy Arozarena.
Well, these days we know teams, you know, they put a game plan together for every hitter in a lineup. But a guy like this, they circle him, make sure he doesn't beat you. So you know they put in a little extra time and effort and on how they're going to approach him. He can be a huge difference maker when he's hot. So it's going to be fun to see how they try to work him right here.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. Next pitch has popped up. Hernandez makes the play. Two down.
That is good. The second baseman.
Lau at the plate. Fourth in the AL and RBIs. In there, and it's 0-1. Arozarena on third with two out. Little trouble with this one behind the plate. Runner stays put at third. The 1-1. Fouls one off out of play back to our left. Two outs. And another ball. Two outs with a runner at third.
The idea was right. Looking to locate that fastball up and in. He just missed his spot a little bit.
And now the lefty swings and misses. Struck him out.
I think the key is arm action on the changeup. When you can sell it like a fastball, you drop the velocity, you get the swing and miss, and you walk off the field.
Back here in Detroit, and towing the slab here, Big Tyler Glasnow. Singy, he's kind of a road warrior, yeah?
I definitely say so. You know, some guys shrink a little bit on the road. They're so used to just, you know, having the comforts of being at home and having the fans behind them. But this guy seems to thrive in adversity and being in some hostile environment. So when you have a player like this on your team that goes out there and competes, you definitely like your chances away from your home ballpark.
Glasnow, ready to deals. just off the outside edge. Two balls, no strikes. And that's in for a strike. And a 2-1 on the way.
That's ball three.
This one lifted in the air, left field. A Rosarena after it. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down. Let's take a check of the Tigers lineup. One guy swinging a hot bat recently, Nick Maton.
And Boog, he's their team leader in home runs, so you know the pitchers on that other side, man. They took a lot of time preparing for him in that pregame meeting. You know, he's got a lot of pop, and it's real pop. It's not fluky at all. He can absolutely change the outlook of a game very quickly, so watch out when he steps in.
Riley Green now at the plate as he swings through strike one. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Puts it away for the out.
Batting third, the designated hitter.
And now up to hit, Miguel Cabrera. And that's in there for strike one. Righty delivers. Strike two.
Man, 91 on the slider right there. That's a hard one. That's a low-end fastball for some guys.
The 0-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. We move on to the second here at Comerica. No score. Back at Comerica Park, top of the second, and stepping in for the Rays, Harold Ramirez. Wentz back to work. Fly ball down the line. And that is a foul ball.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit. Just not able to square it up.
Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
Umpiring behind the plate for us today, Boog, is Mike Fillmore, and he is a good one. He'll reward pitches on the edges a little bit, but the main thing is he doesn't keep you guessing. Once he established that a pitch is a strike, it stays that way.
Kicks and deals. Got it by him for the K.
That is good.
Francisco Mejia coming up to hit. He was 0 for 4 in Wednesday's game. That pitch in for a strike.
0-1.
The next pitch misses. Ball one.
One ball, one strike.
And strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
The next offering misses. And that's ball two.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Gets a piece and stays alive. Kicks and fires.
Three.
Struck him out looking with the off-speed stuff. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now three in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So We'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
Manuel Margot now in the box, comes up empty with a swing there. Ninth in the American League in batting average. Next pitch misses, and that's ball one.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
One, two to Margot. Fights it off. He'll see another. The 1-2. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout. Nothing doing for Tampa. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. We head to the bottom of the second. The batter now, Javier Baez.
The shortstop.
Javier Baez, who hails from Puerto Rico. He was the ninth overall pick in 2011 by the Cubs, and what a fun player to watch. Won the World Series in 2016. He was the NLCS MVP, and of course, on the cover of MLB The Show in 2020.
Yeah, nearly won the MVP in 2018 when he finished runner-up to Christian Yelich, and it's about the only thing he hasn't been able to do.
Next offering misses, ball two.
He's clearly trying to work him away here. Both pitches off the plate. If you really want to put the ball in play, you're going to have to stay back and drive it to the opposite field.
2-0. Foul ball. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2.
I guess you throw it that hard, you can get away with locations like that right down the middle, but I still think it's a dangerous pitch. Don't want to do it again.
Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Had him out front for strike three.
That's a pretty nasty pitch right there. I call it a power curveball in the 80s. It's got so much spin on it, and you really don't have a lot of time to sit back and watch what it's going to do before you have to commit. It was a good one for the swinging strikeout.
Cesar Hernandez, the next to hit, takes outside. And the righty deals. And that's in for a strike.
Looks like a really good fastball today. You can hear that catcher's mitt popping. Looking forward to hearing a lot of that one in this one.
Next pitch is popped up. And puts the squeeze on that, and there's two down.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder, Akil Badu. And he bunts, but that's a foul ball. Nothing, nothing here in the bottom of the second. Next pitch in the dirt, and that is ball one. And a curve misses outside. Next pitch is outside. And a swing and a miss.
Threw that fastball right by him, slightly elevated. That's a confidence boost for this guy out there on the mound. See if he continues to climb the ladder.
Short hop liner, handled it short. Franco on the first. Third out. Tigers are shut down there. We'll move to the third with no score. Of the third inning, now the third baseman, Isaac Paredes. Wentz back to work. Pulls that one foul. Paredes, in his third season, 24 years old, and they went out and made a trade for him last season. Next pitch downstairs, and now it's even, 1-1. And he hits a ground ball right side, and it goes just foul. The pitch. Misses off the plate, and the count's even at 2. And a pitch. Got him. And now one away.
Well, right now he's in cruise control, autopilot, just dominating these hitters. It doesn't look like it's a fun at bat. And all of a sudden, you become in awe of this guy on the mound. Somebody's got to break this thing up. That's 5 straight strikeouts. Got to put a ball in play.
In the air, out to center. Hernandez racing, makes the catch.
That's a really nice play, ranging back into the outfield for that catch. We all know those can be a little tricky, especially if the wind's swirling around out there.
So the lineup flips over. Now at the plate, Randy Arozarena. He's 1-for-1, led off the game with a single. Foul ball there. Arozarena goes 5 feet 11 inches, hitting leadoff in today's game, and he's a former Rookie of the Year. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. Hacks and misses, it's a strikeout. Down in order go the Rays. Still no score. Set for the bottom of the third. Here's the third baseman, Nick Maton.
He's got pop, which is a little sneaky because he's so comfortable with taking his base hits to the opposite field. But he can jump you if you make a mistake.
And ball one. Now fly ball to right center. Tracks it down for the out. One up, one down.
Batting it, the catcher.
Eric Haas up now for the Tigers. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller, good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out. This one in the air, center field. Siri in position. Squeezes it. And there's 2 away.
Batting 9, the first baseman.
And here's the first baseman, Kerry Carpenter. And the pitch is in for a strike. It's 0-1. In the air, out towards left center. High bounce, takes it over the fence. That's an automatic double.
The automatic double kind of feels like enjoying cruise control in your car, Boog. You don't need to keep the pedal down as you cruise into second base. Just no worries in the world. You know what? He put a really good swing on that one.
Here is Austin Meadows. He's 0-for-1. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at all.
Well, they're looking to get on the board first here after that clutch 2-out double made this inning interesting.
Glass now back to work, the 0-1. And a swing and a miss.
Well, you can't expect to get a great pitch to hit with an open base and a runner on second. He's going to have to really tighten up his sights here, make sure that he can barrel up the ball.
Up the middle, Lau. Tosses to first, out number 3. One left for Detroit, and we are still scoreless. Welcome back. John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Yandy Diaz. The wind of the pitch. That's inside.
Well, these Rays, as this game goes on, have to be more disciplined at the plate. So many of their outs have come from weak contact on pitches they're chasing outside of the strike zone. You can't do much of anything with those locations, and that's been true again today.
So now 1-2.
And as a pitcher, when the hitters are swinging at everything, you feel no need to challenge inside the zone. You just keep working the corners and expanding that strike zone and beyond, and they just keep eating right out of your hand.
Goes down looking.
Just absolutely rolling on the mound. He's looking very much on his game in the early parts of this one, Booth. Fully on the attack with these hitters.
That's 7 strikeouts already, so he's got a good pace going, no doubt. Here's Wander Franco. That catches the corner.
0-1.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Quickly into an 0-2 count. Both pitches were down in the zone. I think you set your sights a little bit higher because you'll have a tendency to chase if you look down in that area.
1-2.
That misses the zone. 2-2.
He's really tightening up his hitting zone with 2 strikes here. I love it.
2-2 now. And a ground ball to first. And he takes it himself for the out.
Good fade and sinking action of that changeup. Got that hitter to roll over.
Second base, Brandon Lau.
And now it's Brandon Lau. Scoreless here, but now he's got to deal with a guy who's got some power. Got to be careful when you're talking about a hitter with this type of slug and these type of home run totals. Left-hand batter waits. There's a strike. Line drive, and that's a base hitter to right. And that keeps the inning going.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. At 110 miles per hour on the exit velo, that thing was screaming, and that's some serious bat speed to generate contact like that, and no doubt a higher launch angle sends that thing out of here easily.
Harold Ramirez at the dish. And there's a strike on the outside corner, 0-1. Lau off of first with 2 away. And a foul ball. The pitch goes down swinging for the strikeout. Pulled the string of the changeup. The Rays strand just the one, and we're still knotted at 0. Here at the ballpark, here's Riley Green. Here, the right hitter back to work. A bit behind with that swing. It's strike one.
Had some cut action to it. Velocity pretty good on that slider. So far, moving the ball around nicely.
0-1 now. And that one a little bit high.
1-1.
Popped up. Paredes under it. Hauls it in for the out.
Up next to the Tigers. The designated hitter,
Miguel Cabrera, up now for the Tigers. Swing and a miss. And it's 0-1.
Something I'm noticing in this one is that these guys are aggressive early in the count. It makes you wonder if that was talked about in the hitters meeting before this game started.
Next one misses, and it's 1-1. And a pitch. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Zips it to first. Two up, two down.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Now it's Javier Baez. His first at bat was a strikeout. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Two as he waves at that one.
Just not able to catch up to that velocity.
Next offering upstairs.
Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, you'll look for something down in the zone, but not too far. Don't want to chase that breaking ball in the dirt.
Towards first. Nice grab. Throw to first, and they get the out. Down in order go the Tigers. Through four, still tied. Zip, zip. And welcome back. All set for the start of the inning. Now up for Tampa Bay, Francisco Mejia. The wind to kick the pitch. That's in for a strike.
Well, these Rays just lacking discipline at the plate in this ballgame. They've been chasing pitches outside the zone all game, and it's led to some frustrating moments. They've been fooled quite a bit today.
Checks his swing. Now it appealed to first. And he held back, according to Rusty Valentine. 1-2. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Makes a nice grab at a full sprint. And there's one down. Here's Manuel Margot. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. In there for strike one.
Boog, over 80% of his first pitches are strikes. If you're doing that, you could have a really good day out there on the mound.
Swing, and this one's bounced to the ground. Tosses to first, and that quickly two away.
Now batting, third baseman, Isak.
Isak Paredes now. That one's in there, 0-1. Lined into right. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. That is the inning. Rays held in check here. Halfway through this one, still no score. Back here in Detroit, bottom of the inning. And here is Cesar Hernandez. The right-hander back to work. That one laced to center and a base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff dive.
Up next for the Tigers.
A
Only two hits allowed so far tonight, Boog, so I don't think that one will disrupt his momentum all that much. You know, he's really been on top of his game, commanding his pitches all night long.
Now a drag bunt, third base side. To first, and he beats it.
Maybe a little small ball is exactly what the doctor ordered to rev up this offense, and they've been pretty quiet all game, so maybe this wakes them up a bit and helps them get on the board.
Nick Maton up now for the Tigers. 0 for 1 with a flyout. That's off the mark, and it's 1-0. Hernandez over at second. Badu at first with no outs. Next offering is down low. And now 2-0.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
2-0 the count. Here it comes.
That one missed. Well, I would expect in this 3-0 count, you're taking all the way. See if they'll walk you.
And that'll load the bases.
He's making things difficult for himself right now out there on the mound. But, you know, his confidence should still be high enough to get out of this. But he's going to have to buckle down right here.
Bases loaded. Nobody out. And up next for Detroit, Eric Haas. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Well, this is a tough situation with the bases loaded, but the healthiest mindset is just try to get outs one hitter at a time.
And the 1-0. That one drifts inside.
Pressure's on right here. 2-0 count, bases loaded. You don't want to fall to a 3-ball count and then walk in a run. He's got to challenge the hitter right here.
At the belt and fires. Ground ball up the middle. Diving, and he can't make the play. One runs in. The second run scores. And they lead by two. Vidal Brujan coming into the game now as the injury replacement. First and second. No outs. And next up for the Tigers, Kerry Carpenter. Doubled his first time up. This one in the dirt. No advance. Good job behind the dish. That one ripped. And it's a one hopper off the wall. Should be extra bases. One run is in. Now two runs score, and they lead by four.
Back-to-back base hits. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and lifted into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
And the Rays manager making his way towards the mound now as he will make the move. That'll be it for Glasnow. Just never found his groove, wasn't able to settle in. New arm coming on, back in a moment. And the Rays, they go to the bullpen. Shane Baz.
Well, you see the ERA, very solid, and that doesn't always tell you the whole story, but he's been really good so far this year.
Austin Meadows now.
And Boog, I'd say he's due.
Into the outfield, base hit. And they get it in quickly. First and third now with nobody out. Jonathan Aranda coming into the game now as the injury replacement. Now playing first. So they're at the corners now. And next to hit for Detroit, Riley Green. Aranda. Swing and a miss. And that's strike one.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation. Well, maybe a long relief guy to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable. But I want to start that load a little bit sooner because of the good velo.
Gonna count one and two. No outs. Runners at first and third. Next pitch misses inside. Now two and two. Next offering is fouled back. And a pitch. Just missed.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with a three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Payoff pitch. Good job to fight that one off. Runners on the corners, no outs. And a 3-2. Ripped on a line. Margot makes the catch. Runner tags from third. In comes the run from third. It's 5-0. And now the DH, Miguel Cabrera. Check swing, but he went too far. Slider right there. Swing and a miss as he was out front.
Two really good back-to-back sliders. Now in an 0-2 count. He's feeling real confident about finishing this hitter off. He can go anywhere he wants.
Next one is off the plate. And a count 1-2.
I don't think he was trying to miss by that much in an 0-2 count. Just tried to overthrow that pitch.
And the right-hander deals. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Definitely made him chase a little bit out of the zone right there. I don't think that's a strike if he takes it. Pretty textbook pitching. Get ahead in the count, get the guy in the box on his heels, and then force him to chase your pitch where he doesn't have much of a chance to do any damage.
They take the force out. That's the third out. So five runs in the inning as they bat around. Five innings complete. It's the Tigers 5, the Rays nothing. Welcome back. All right, we go to the top half of inning number 6. And stepping in is the speedy Jose Siri. And here it comes. There's a strike. Siri, 27 years old, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. And takes low for ball one.
Where do you even begin with the talent we've seen from the Dominican Republic? Vladdy, Big Poppy, Pedro, the list goes on and on.
Gets the call. And the count 1-2. And down on strikes he goes. And one away.
Probably showing some pretty dominating stuff out there in this one, not just in terms of swing and miss, but also in terms of command. You know, all the strikeouts, they just kind of speak for themselves, but when you don't walk anyone, you're demonstrating that you have the confidence in your abilities to truly go right after opposing batters.
So the batting order turns over. Randy Arozarena next to hit for the Rays. There's a strike.
He's been going after these guys consistently, and as a result, he's been able to keep his pitch count low, throwing the ball very well right now.
That one fouled off.
This is a very important inning here. After scoring all those runs, you want your pitcher to come out and just mow them down. The offense has worked hard. It's shut down inning time.
Hard hit, right side. Carpenter takes it himself. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
The batter, number two, designated hitter, Yandy Diaz.
Yandy Diaz now. Diaz measures 6 feet, 2 inches, 215 pounds. He's usually a third baseman, but today he's the designated hitter. In the air to left center. Meadows brings it in for the third out. Nothing doing for the offense that time. We go to the bottom half of inning number six, and the 5-6-7 slots do up. It's the Tigers 5, the Rays nothing. Back at Comerica Park, Cesar Hernandez up to the plate.
The second baseman, Jacob Hernandez.
The pitch. Ball one there.
Count 1-0.
The pitch. And that one wrapped foul. And he deals. And downstairs.
Two balls, one strike.
The 2-1. There's a swing and a miss.
Two balls, two strikes.
Lifted in the air, right center field. Siri sizing it up. Makes the grab after a long run. And there's one down.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
Slice the other way. That's a base hit.
Third baseman.
Nick Maton up now for the Tigers. He swings and misses at the first pitch. 0-1. Badu, the base runner at first with one out. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
Wow, no fair right there. I mean, that slider didn't move till the very last moment. Incredibly difficult.
Rudder takes off. In there for strike three. Throw safe. That's a stolen base.
Clearly not content with the lead they're working with right now, and I like that. I don't think you can get comfortable with a five-run lead in today's game, and now they've got a good chance of adding on.
So up next, Eric Haas. His righty-lefty splits there. Swing and a miss. 1-1. And the slider catches the zone. The 0-2. And the pitch is outside. Ball one. Runner at second. Two down. Ground ball to the right side. Gloves it on the dive. And that's a nice play to end the inning.
First, it looks like making the stop is the hardest part, but feeding to the pitcher on the move, I think even tougher. Great job of hitting that moving target. They're going to be fired up in the dugout.
New pitcher for the Tigers, Trevor Rosenthal.
And you know, bullpen guys can struggle sometimes when they're called upon with big leads because it just doesn't have the same intensity as a tight game. So we'll see how sharp he is. Your mental toughness matters in situations like this as well.
Franco.
Here comes a pitch. Franco in the box now. No balls and a strike.
Well, an at bat can be a little bit of a dance. Strike one here, but a few more pitches. We'll see how it turns out.
The 0-1. Good eye right there. Oh, That's in there. And the count 1-2.
Well, that's really the money spot. Down and away, if you can locate that consistently, it's going to be real tough for guys to square that up. That's what you love to see relievers do coming out of that bullpen.
The 1-2.
That's ball two.
That one ran inside, almost got him. Three, two. Got him swinging.
Well, he showed a lot of conviction with the fastball there, not just because of the velocity, but also the ability to command it on the inside part of the plate. The last thing you want to do with two strikes is just get too far in there and it gets away and it hits the batter. So when I see a two-strike fastball bunch up a guy like that, it tells me there's a lot of confidence in that pitch.
Next offering is down low. Good eye in that spot.
Tried to backdoor him with that slider right there, but just missed off the plate. Good pitch, though.
That one in for a strike, 2-2. One down, base is empty. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Chance to strike out the side now. You talk about the benefits, the advantages of relievers who can come in and get the swing and miss, whether it's inherited runners or maybe a little jam that they get into themselves.
Yeah.
Knowing that they can miss the bat, tell you what, that's huge and can change the ballgame.
The 0-1. That's a little bit low. And fouled off. The 1-2. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And it's a 3-up, 3-down inning. Nothing doing for Tampa. It's 5-0. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the seventh, and now the first baseman, Kerry Carpenter. The pitch. And it's fouled away. And a foul ball. Oh, and two now. Swings and misses, and one out now.
Oh, there he gets the slider in on his hands, and it just eats him off. You know, it's hard to get the bat around on a pitch like that in tight. You just feel like you're crowded on the inside part of the plate. Can't get any extension. That's one he definitely should have laid off of.
Meadows in the box here lets that one go for a ball. Next pitch is outside. There's the strike at the knees. Next offering, pop foul off to the right out of play. Righty to the plate. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. The Rosarena makes the grab, and there are two outs.
Now batting, center fielder.
Two outs, base is empty. Now the number two hitter, Riley Green. First pitch, not close. And there's a ball.
He's been raking in recent games, and a big reason why, getting ahead in counts. He's been able to do that consistently, and you see the results.
Left-hand hitter waits. That misses the zone, and that's ball three. And that's ball four.
That just came apart right there. Four pitch walk, and guy at the plate was not going to help him out by swinging at something out of the zone.
So now the DH spot, Miguel Cabrera. Swing and a miss. Strike one. Green, the runner at first with two gone. And that's downstairs and outside.
I got a ball, one strike.
And that one lifted in the air center field. Siri in position. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Tigers leave one as they are unable to add to their 5-0 lead. So out of the pen comes the right-hander, Will Vest. He last pitched 2 days ago. And now the catcher for the Rays, Francisco Mejia. And a pitch. That catches the zone for a strike. It's 0-1.
Establishing both ends of the zone is critical. Most times guys are wanting to get hitters out down, but if you can get them to look up, get a called strike, that's going to make that strike zone a lot bigger.
Next offering, pop foul off to the right out of play. Righty delivers. Fouls it back with two strikes. Back foot slider ties him up, struck him out.
Stood absolutely no chance on that slider right there. And I don't mean to laugh, but that's a tough one. I mean, pretty much a perfect strikeout pitch. I mean, it looks like a fastball middle in. Kind of has cutter action, and it just bunches you up to where you can't get your hands through and the barrel to it. And not much you can do unless you recognize the spin early and you spit on it.
Here's your one. And he gets that fastball by him upstairs.
He can live up in the zone all game if guys will chase it. That's just too much velocity. Hitters got to look down in the zone.
The pitch. And 1-2.
Caught a break right there. Pretty good pitch on the outside corner.
Got him looking. Now two away.
Oh, nice job right there. He struck him out twice. The pitch before looked like it was strike three. Doesn't get the call. Bears down. Throws another quality pitch for the strikeout.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Isaac Paredes. Swinging a foul straight back. Your one. This one in the air right field. Puts the squeeze on it. And that is the third out of the inning. Rays go in order. 1-2-3. Still looking at that 5-0 deficit. A new pitcher in the game, Kevin Kelly.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
The pitch. And that one fouled off. And a big swing and a miss. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch, top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
And he grounds one to the right side. And foul ball. And the 0-1. And that one missing low. Action in the pen down there. Jalen Beeks warming up for manager Kevin Cash. Swing and a miss, and it's 1-2. And look out, as that one ran in and got him. He had him 1-2, and he ends up hitting him with a pitch.
You have any memorable hit-by-pitches yourself? Maybe high school, college?
No, but I almost did get decapitated by a foul ball at Old Tiger Stadium. Right back to the mound. Could be an easy two. DeFranco for one, and it's a double play to end the inning. Nothing doing here this half. Through eight full, it's the Tigers 5, the Rays nothing. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Tyler Holton.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
And now it's Jose Siri. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. That one out to right. Badu glides to his left. And it's caught for the out. So the Rays batting order turns over. Now it's Randy Arozarena. Holton, a 6'2 southpaw, 26 years old. They got him off of waivers earlier this season. Swings through that one, 0-1. Way out front for strike two. The 0-2. In the dirt. Hess up with it to first. In time for the second out. Good job to clean it up after the drop third strike. So it's their last chance in this one. Yandy Diaz next to hit for the Rays. And first offering is fouled off. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. That clips the zone, and that is strike two.
This guy's not wasting any pitches. Hitters got to get into swing mode. This is a good time to expand the zone. Throw something maybe down in the dirt.
Gonna count 1-2.
That turns out to be a really good take right there, but you don't want to end this game with the bat on your shoulder.
And that one is lifted in the air, and that'll do it. The Tigers take the series opener here at home.
Well, when you reel off 8 wins in a row, you're this close to double digits, and now all of a sudden it's a challenge within a challenge to get 2 more wins to get to 10. But there's definitely a high level of confidence that these guys are playing at right now, and that's one of those things. You don't want to rock the boat. You don't want to disturb things. Make sure the clubhouse guy is giving you the same good food he's been giving you all along, and you can keep this win streak going.
5-0 the final in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.
First for the victorious Tigers, 5 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Rays, no runs on only 2 hits, no errors.